anti-imperialist, because the colonization came from within the countries at the hands of their own elites, which is oppression. And in Bolivia especially, where 70% of the population is indigenous, for Evo Morales to be the first indigenous president, it's a scandal. And people felt that. But he did not win by being indigenous. He won because he had a very progressive social and economic program and pushed it through. After all, we know countries where you have indigenous leaders who are complete traitors to their own people. So it's you can't purely see it in terms of origins. It's a dangerous business. If you look at the history of Africa, all the countries have indigenous leaders, but it's a mess. South America, there is a shift now because the power of the old Creole elites is being broken in country after country. And in Venezuela, you could hear many people from the old elites referring to Chavez in an extremely racist language. They said, Chavez, we don't trust him. Sometimes even intellectuals on the so-called left, we don't trust Chavez. Why? He's a Zambo. A Zambo is mixed race between indigenous and slave. So there is a great deal of that here. I remember a few years ago I was at a literature festival in Paraty, in Brazil, and there was a dinner with lots of bourgeois people sitting around like this, and one woman, Brazilian, light-skinned woman, said, Chavez was recently in London. I said, yeah, and thousands of people came to see him. And she said, but probably thousands of Asians and people like that. And I said, no, no. Many, many people, I said, whose skin color is much lighter than yours, came to greet Chavez. So even in Brazil, you get that attitude quite strongly. And the fact that the heritage of slavery in Brazil hasn't been, it's gone, of course, it's not the same and there is a mix, but you don't see many black politicians, or even, dare I say it, black journalists, or black professors. Maybe there are some. I have never seen them, and I've been coming to Brazil for a very long time. So these problems, even in Brazil, which has this image, and it is a mixed country, there has been a lot of cross-mixing. That's absolutely true. But despite that, there is still the hierarchy of skin color, which exists. When I was, the first time I was in Venezuela after Chavez's election victory, I really felt this very strongly. And normally, if you don't live in South America, you don't think about it. You say, South America, they're all people from the South. But big, big problems. And in Ecuador, I don't think that that Correa, who is a very intelligent leader, has paid enough attention to this problem. But it's... or in Mexico, which is another mixed society. But you continue to have the problem. I mean, the way they treated the uprising in Oaxaca. Oaxaca is a 90% indigenous city. It was one of the few places in South America, Oaxaca, where you could see indigenous people with a smile on their face. Not many. Guatemala, for instance, yes, of course. But in Oaxaca, you could see that, and they crushed that uprising a few years ago, very brutally. So this is a problem which will go, but the solution lies not simply on the level of who is indigenous, but on a level which embraces that, but has a social and economic answer to the problem.